Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty McKean from Nao Nails. Guess who's back? JJ's back! Yeah! And she has bare naked nails. My favourite kind of nail, because I can create some crazy stuff. So, because JJ's got nothing on her nails at the minute, I'm going to show you prep and go through it thoroughly and show you exactly what I do. I love doing a prep video, especially on somebody that hasn't had nails on for a long time. So all JJ's been doing...
We've worked it out. It's a very, very long time.
It's nearly a year.
February was the last time you did your friend's nails. How shocking's that?
What a shit friend I am. Terrible. But JJ's used the skills that she's learned along this journey of being a nail model. And she's been doing her own gel polish, hasn't she?
Yeah. Just gel. I haven't cheated on you.
You've not gone to another nail tech.
I haven't been to anybody. Loyal.
Yeah, loyal to the core. So yeah, so we're going to prep this hand and show you exactly what we're going to do. We're going to do it a little bit different on two fingers so I can just show you the difference. You'll know what I'm on about. Let's go. So we have, if we look at JJ's nails, I can see we have some demarcations in the nail, can you see? And she's been prepping her nails. We do have a few thin spots. She's already...
You've been over-filing.
You've admitted that, haven't you?
Oh yeah. It's always a quick job.
You need an 80 grit file on her pristine fingers.
It's probably, actually, it's one of your really old files that I've still got.
Yeah, we need to give you some files, don't we? So we've got, you know, we'll still need to prep because you can see there is shine. See, we will still need to remove the shine. Obviously, we'll still have some demarcations. I don't want to, you know, completely obliterate that top layer. And then you can see we've got some stress areas here. So basically these little white spots are nothing to do with calcium. They are to do with where the nail bends. When it bends, it just separates the fibres and creates this little bit of a white spot here. So that's all that is. It's nothing to worry about. Oh God, I feel like I haven't seen your nails for such a long time. I just want to show you JJ's natural C-curve. So they're quite flat here, and then they really hoik down here.
Hoik.
They go hoik, hoik.
They hoik.
Hoik. So they just really sort of curve there. And you can see this one. Can you see how it really presses into the skin? It actually leaves a bit of a dent as well. Because they do really curve. Same on this one. Look at this little one. That's really pressing into the finger.
What does that mean?
Not uncomfortable, though.
Don't you know it's a thing?
Yeah, it's just because it's naturally grown like that, it'll naturally sort of press into that part of the skin. There's nothing wrong with that. Sometimes some people can be uncomfortable with that, especially on toenails.
Yeah, you can get ingrown toenails. I've had that before.
Yeah, from things like this. Yeah. Yeah, and then what they do if it's a toenail, you can go to the chiropodist and they will actually remove...
The root
right from down this side.
That's what I've done on
it. Do it on both sides, yeah.
No, just one on that side, one on that side.
Yeah, so it was just that side that was causing the irritation. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to push back the cuticles on two of the nails and I'm not going to push these back. And I want you to see if you can tell the difference between pushing it back and not actually pushing it back. Because we're going to prep with an electric file, I don't feel that there is a need to push them back. It's adding a step in that's not needed, but I want you to want to kind of prove my point. If you get what I mean.
I am right. And it's on camera.
Yeah. So I'm going to push these back. And as I push them back, can you see the cuticle that's left on the nail? So it starts to go flaky because we're disturbing it by pushing that epinicium. Back.
I love that word.
Do you like the epinicium and the hypernicium?
Yeah.
You missed that word.
Yeah.
So we're going to push those back. Uh-huh. Same on this one. Let's see what happens here. Yeah, and we can see, you're able to scrape, you know, some of it off, but you don't want to be aggressive with that metal tool because, you know, you can cause damage. And you can cause these, see these little white spots? You can actually cause those by pressing too hard with a metal tool. Now, you think you've got a little bit of top coat on, maybe?
Yeah, or the base coat, where I haven't really filed it enough. I just want to get rid of the gel that I had on, just so...
Let me just have my wipe and see. So this is just acetone. It's pure acetone. Yeah, you can see where that's a bit shiny there.
Oh my God, isn't that clever?
So that's a little bit of product there. That's the base coat from your gel. And here too, there and there. That'll come off when we prep it then. And if we wipe those, see if there's anything on those before we use the electric file. So here, can you pick that up? Mm. You can see the little sort of patches, and I can feel that. Can you feel the difference? Mm. I don't know if you can hear that. It's a little bit squeaky. Feels totally different, this area does, to the naked nail. Yeah, there's a little bit on there as well. So just little patches, that's all. Yeah, not visible at the time, though.
No.
Not until we sort of wipe over with the acetone, because the acetone will dehydrate the natural nail, but obviously won't dehydrate the base layer, your sort of base coat, because, well, it can't. So that's why you can then really see what's going on. So we're going to use a cuticle bit, and we're going to go up the side gently, and then notice the angle. I can go up the side like this, sort of pulling down. You can push forward, but you don't want to push up here in this angle. You need to change the angle so you are leading the way with the handle of your electric file. You're not doing this. You don't want to do that because there's more chance of basically causing damage. And as we go round, I am pushing that cuticle back as well, and also getting rid of the cuticle that's attached to the nail. So I'm going to come down this side, and as I come down this side, can you see how we are exfoliating this skin here as well? Have a little bit of a callus built up. I'm going to switch the rotation so I can really come down this side here and exfoliate that side a little bit as well.
The weather bad outside?
It's windy.
So let's do the same with this. So you can work from the centre and pull down. So I'm doing this because my rotation is now going anti-clockwise. So if you have an e-file, doesn't matter what e-file you have, it will have a forward and reverse, and I'm now in reverse. So when you're coming down, when you're looking at the person, it's on your right-hand side, you want it in reverse, and that will push the skin away. And then we're going to go to forward, and we can start from the centre again. And that'll push that cuticle back, leading with your handpiece, not the actual point of the tool. Let's just exfoliate that a little bit.
Oh, my nails are having a right pumpy.
Exfoliating
and everything.
It's like having a facial, duck. It's just a nail shop.
A nail shop.
So now, because the rotation is going forward, I'm going to come to this side. I don't need to keep changing it. You want to work with the rotation that you've got set. So So we are getting rid of the cuticle that's attached to the nail and also opening up these sides and kind of lifting the skin away and giving it a bit of TLC. What we have noticed as well is that JJ sometimes has overfiled the top, so very flat. So I kind of feel like maybe she's been straight on the top like that and then come down the side like this, which has kind of made it even squarer, but the nail plate is squarer than it would be if it hadn't been filed, if that makes sense.
The only time I file my nails is when I'm filing the gel polish off, which is probably why I don't do any sort of paying any attention. I just keep filing till the colour's off.
Yeah. So you need to rotate maybe a little bit more.
Well, if you've got skin colour on, and then you just keep going and going and going till the blood.
Then I ring Casey.
You're like a koala. You're like a koala. Yeah. Oh, no, that's talking about koalas,
aren't you? But why are you not soaking it off?
Because I haven't got time for that. I literally just file.
Like, ain't nobody got time for that. Yeah. Do you know how quick it'll file? It'll soak off as quick as you file, isn't it?
All right. I know. I literally just file it off. Quick, put another coat on, and then I'm off.
She doesn't have time for this anymore.
She doesn't have time for bloody us anymore.
Oh, here we go. You're never in the country.
Well, you don't have time for me when I'm in the country.
I don't know when you're in the country.
Well, true.
We film all the time.
She's always bloody working. Working. Right, let's dust that off and then we're going to go in with a proximal fold bit. You could use like a proximal fold bit or you could use like a round bit. You could use sort of either of those really. I prefer using that one if I'm honest. So we are in forward rotation. So I'm now going to go across the skin and exfoliate.
Delish.
Delish. Look at that. Just exfoliates the skin. It's not going to cut it. Obviously, if you did it for too long, maybe you'd cut it. You just want to exfoliate that cuticle. And obviously, your cuticles haven't had this for a good while, have they? So you can either flip the rotation or you can move the positioning of your electric file to keep that rotation pushing away from the natural nail. So when you become quite, you know, good at this, you're able just change the handpiece rather than flipping the rotation. And this will also push back the cuticle as well. And it kind of does it gently. So we're going to use a 240 grit file. I have taken off the edges. I've taken a coarse file. So I've got a 120 grit file. You could use any high grit file from 120 up to your 80 grit file. Just to take off those edges. Because they will be very sharp when you use a new file. This is a new file. We do not want to cut. So because we're doing a brand new set, we are going to get rid of the free edge, leaving sort of between 1.5 mil of free edge. And then we're going to skip over, and I'm not adding a lot of pressure. I'm just skipping over to remove surface shine. And then can you see the difference here? That is the product. So that's the base coat for the gel polish. Just skipping over, obviously, because we have some thin patches. All right.
I'm a hairdresser, not a nail tech.
I think you've not done too bad, I don't think. You think we've learned that you need to soak them off?
Yeah, okay.
It doesn't take that long, no. Can I have some
gel polish? Gel polish does not take long to soak off.
I know.
You're a lazy bitch.
I am. I literally file and reapply at about 12 o'clock at night before I go to bed because my nails start to lift and I can't deal with, you know, you get put your hand through hair and then a little bit of hair goes up.
Go gets under the gel polish when it's lifting or if it's, oh yeah, not good. Right, so when we look at this nail now, I can tell that I've got rid of that base coat. I'm wiping over with the gel residue wipe off solution. So that's what we're going to do on all these nails now. So I'm going to wipe over with gel residue wipe off solution, also pushing back at the same time. So we're cleaning and making sure the cuticle's back. And can you tell any difference between those not having it pushed back with the metal tool and those being pushed back with the tool first?
None whatsoever.
So it's pointless.
I did expect one of them to be redder than the other, but you can't see anything.
Yeah, so it's just, if you're doing an electric file prep, then you do not need to push back with a metal tool, which is pretty good to know. Because obviously some people skip steps, and there are steps that you can skip, but there are steps that you can't. That is a step you can skip as long as you're doing an electric file routine. If you're just pushing back with a metal tool and then going ahead with the file, fair enough, but if you're using an electric file, you do not need to use the metal tool, the metal cuticle pusher, to push it back first. Because this is how they should look, and they are ready for application. Going to do some acrylic nails, so I'll see you in the next video for that. Bye-bye. Back, back.